On this channel, I've said over and over how important it is for me to photograph my family and the people that I love and care about. And this video is really just about that, just to show how important it is and to really get people out there to do the same, because those photos will mean something entirely different when a certain time comes. If you follow me on Instagram or Twitter, you probably already know where this is going, but I'm gonna go ahead and just kinda go over some things that have happened in the last couple of weeks for anybody who doesn't know, and also just to really kinda make this point. On February 4th, just less than a couple of weeks ago, my dad, who was 79, had a severe stroke. He had a massive blood clot in the carotid artery of his neck on his right side, and he was sitting down to have breakfast and suffered a very, very severe stroke. It was within a matter of seconds. He was sitting down to have breakfast with my mom. She made him breakfast, set his plate down, and went to grab him a drink out of the fridge, and she said something to him, and she heard his speech was kind of slurred. She turned around and she saw that he was having a stroke. Just two nights before all this had happened, we were all out there at their house, and he was chasing our daughter Nora around the house. He was holding our son Elliot. He was just, you know, like any other day. He was perfectly healthy, or so we thought. You know, he was doing really good. And all of this happened on Saturday morning on the 4th. And on February 7th, he passed away. This was something that was very, very unexpected. Within 36 hours of the stroke happening, we knew that he wasn't gonna live. And the nurses and doctors kind of sat us down and they basically let us know that the swelling in his brain was so severe that if they did everything they could to keep him alive, he was only gonna have, you know, a 20% chance of living. And if he did, he would be, you know, on a ventilator, on a feeding tube, he would be in a nursing home the rest of his life, and he would not be there. He would basically be a vegetable at that point. And if my dad said it once, he said it 100 times that that is not how he was, you know, going to go out, basically. You know, he watched both of his parents spend a long time in the nursing home in the last few years of their lives. We saw my mom's father. We watched him just suffer his last leg, you know, in hospitals and in hospice care. And my dad always said, that's not living. And whenever they told us that, we knew that that's not what he would want, and we went and talked to him and, you know, explained to him what was going on, and he made that decision that that's not how he was going to go, and that he wanted to go peacefully, and that he was ready, basically, given, you know, the circumstances. And each of us, one-on-one, got to sit down with him and talk to him and say our goodbyes. And it was something that, again, happened completely out of nowhere, but having that time just to sit and talk with him and say what we had to say and, you know, say our goodbyes, and for him to hear every word and still be there with us, that made a world of difference, obviously. So it's been extremely hard. It's going to continue to be hard, but over the last couple of years, for years, I've always been very, very close with my dad. You guys have probably seen in several videos where I share photos of him, especially when we're out working. You know, my dad and I work together all year, and we've been doing that for many, many years now. And I actually am going to be taking over his business. That was our plan for this spring. He was going to kind of go out with me a few weeks and get me trained and, you know, turn the business over to me. And I'll still be taking it over. I just, you know, won't have him right there over my shoulder. But over the last few years, I've made a stronger effort to basically just bug him and let me take photos of him. And it was something that for years he would always, you know, quit. That's what he would always say anytime he would hear me taking pictures of him. And I begged him basically to just let me take some actual portraits of him, photos where it's just me and him, and, you know, he's actually looking at me at the camera and just being himself, and to kind of put that guard down, basically. And I was actually able to do that, you know, on a handful of occasions over the last couple of years. I think my wife Molly helped make that happen by, you know, insisting that he let me do it, because pretty much anything that we needed my dad to do, or if we needed to get a message to him and for him to actually listen, because he could be stubborn at times, we would basically have Molly do it, because he, you know, Molly could do no wrong in his eyes, basically. And, you know, I got to make a good amount of photos of my dad, and I knew that they would mean something to me entirely differently, you know, when a certain time came. And while I thought we had many, many years before, you know, that time would come, for everything to happen so suddenly, I am more than thankful for all of the photos I got to make of him. Obviously, all of the memories and, you know, good times that we've had, that's been the one thing that I've held on to through all of this, just because, you know, he didn't suffer. He didn't have, this last chapter of his life was just like the rest. I mean, he was himself until the very end. If you knew my dad, you knew he was a one-of-a-kind character. Everybody thought the world of him. He was my best friend. And, you know, I've been able to just kind of focus on that and be extremely thankful that all of the memories we have of him, he was himself. And, you know, they were really, really good times. And, you know, the fact that I was able to take those photos of him being himself, they mean the world to me. And, you know, I was able to have something that I can remember him by, and photos that whenever you see them, they are my dad. That was one thing that everybody commented on at the calling hours and the funeral. They saw all the photos we had up, and everybody said, "That was your dad," you know? And it's a really good feeling knowing that I have these photos, and that, you know, everybody that sees them, they're going to remember him for who he was, you know, because they're honest photos of him. This photo in particular, this is a print that I had done by a lab, a new lab, Tweak Imaging, in Knoxville, Tennessee. And I've been working with them for about a month or so now, and I've been absolutely loving the quality of their prints. But this photo here is probably my favorite photo I've ever made of my dad. Him in his Marine hat, and it just, it looks like him. It's a photo that, whenever I shot it, I just thought, there's my dad, and that was, you know, it was a good photo of him. But this, to me, is kind of the portrait of my dad. It was what we used for his obituary, and it was a big print that we had on display. And these kind of photos mean the world to me and to our family now, you know, especially, I mean, they meant a lot before, but especially now. And you know, this whole video is basically just to show you guys how important it is to take photos of your family, of your friends, anybody you love and care about. If they insist that you don't, just keep pressing, because I pressed my dad for years to just actually let me take some good photos of him and not have to be sneaky with every single photo. There are a lot of photos of my dad that I shot that he never actually got to see, or didn't even know that I took them, because I had to be, you know, sneaky about it, because he would always just turn away and he didn't want to be, you know, in front of the camera. But I'm very, very thankful that, you know, he actually let me make these photos. They mean, again, just entirely, they mean something so much more now. And I'm very thankful that we have these photos. So, this whole video, again, I just wanted to, share this with you guys, because a lot of people, you know, they reached out to me on Instagram and Twitter and Facebook and email, and, the response, just the amount of people that have reached out with their love and support and prayers and everything, it really does mean the world. It has helped me and my entire family more than people realize, and you know, it's something we're extremely thankful for. And you know, I wanted to share this with you guys, because I had some people ask about what all had happened, so I thought maybe this would be helpful. And also, I just wanted to really really kind of make a statement about how important it is to take photos of your loved ones, because you know, you don't know when you're gonna basically lose that opportunity. And I'm very thankful that as unexpected as everything was, I was, you know, able to get these photos while I could. So thank you guys again for everything. I'm gonna go ahead and just leave you guys with some of my favorite photos that I've made of my dad.